95SX and the Two Girls and a Guy Morning Show.
Ready?
Yes.
We are joined by Joey and Big Joey and Caroline. How are you doing this morning, Joey?
Good.
Good. And what are you here to talk about?
The cystic fibrosis walk.
The cystic fibrosis walk. It's coming up very soon, right?
Right.
Saturday, May 2nd at 9 o'clock, the Mount Pleasant Palmetto Island County Park. We did it last year and it was so much fun, right?
Right.
It was. And can more people join the Peanut Patrol?
Yes.
Yes? What do they have to do to join it?
They have to raise money for it and just be part of the event.
And for people out there that maybe don't know what cystic fibrosis is, can you tell us what it is?
Yes. It's a disease. It clogs your lungs and makes it hard to get healthier and get all the nutrients out. And it gets it harder to do that, and that's what CF is.
That is, Mosa. You did a really good job with that explanation.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Big Joey, tell us a little bit more about little Joey and how you guys found out about cystic fibrosis, how you found out that he had it.
At 6 weeks old, we were told that he was failing to thrive, which to parents is not necessarily the best words to use.
Mm-hmm.
And so we went to the doctor, and the doctor said, you're going to the hospital.
Oh, geez.
And we don't know what's going on, and we're going to figure it out. Well, after a week or so in the hospital, we still didn't have any answers. So they transferred us to another hospital. And within about probably 12 hours of being there, we had a diagnosis, which sounds great. It was like, okay, well, let's fix it. Well, it turns out it wasn't fixable. It was called cystic fibrosis, and it means that his body doesn't process salt. And that sounds like a simple thing. You know, we all hear about, you know, well, put less salt in your diet and don't shake it on top of your popcorn, do that. Well, it turns out that it's really critical for your body to work. And so his body not being able to use it, it produces all sorts of sticky mucus and all throughout the body, and it causes problems with digestion,
breathing. I mean, you can hear it right now in the cough that he has.
And that's a mild one. I mean, it's sort of the sound of CF is a constant cough and a sometimes a little bit extra comes up, too.
I know we've talked about this before because we've had Joey on the show quite a few times. He's my boyfriend. I fell in love with you guys from the minute that I met you. And, you know, years ago, the lifespan wasn't as long.
Yes, it has consistently grown because of the research and the effect that the doctors have had and the money raised by Cystic Fibrosis Foundation.
Right. And I, obviously I'm not bringing it up to, you know, get anybody sad or upset because, I mean, it's well into the adult years, but it's just so important that we raise money for this so that they can research so that it can get even further and that we can cure this. I mean, that's what this is all about.
Well, when it was first named as a disease, children were lucky to make it to elementary school.
Mm-hmm.
And there's an old proverb, God bless the child that tastes like salt, meaning that pretty much back then that, you know, all you could do is just wish that they went peacefully. Well, now through research and years, we're well into the 30s of a life expectancy. That's great. It's not good enough for mom and dads
right.
all across the country. And, you know, we don't want to ever have the thought that that's, you know, acceptable. And that's still, that's the median age. That means there's some that live longer and some that don't live as long. We need that to be 100.
And that's why we need people to support.
That's right. That's right.
And help out. And definitely join the walk. You can go to cff.org. It's the Great Strides Walk. We will be there Saturday, May 2nd. I'm so excited about it. I love being a part of it. And Joey, what's your favorite part of the walk?
Seeing all the people who came. I liked when I saw my friend there.
Who'd you see?
My friend from K4, Nicholas.
Nicholas. Very cool. What else is going on with you, Joey? How's school going?
Good.
First grade's coming up.
Yes.
What do you think's different from kindergarten to first grade?
You don't have snack time.
What's your favorite song on the radio right now?
I don't want to write you a love song because you asked me to and you need one. I'm not gonna write you a love song because you tell me you need it.
Good job.
That was good. Sarah Bareilles needs to move over.
Hey, buddy, I got a question for you.
Yes, Daddy?
Can you tell everybody what's different about your body now?
Got 5 pounds.
You gained 5 pounds. You look so good.
How did you gain those?
By doing what my mom and dad said.
And did we also put a tube in your tummy?
Yes.
How do you like that?
It kind of sometimes hurts.
Now, why did Joey have to have the feeding tube?
Because I lost some pounds a couple months ago.
Beyond the lung issues and cystic fibrosis, food absorption and nutrition absorption is a huge, huge issue. He has to take enzymes every time that he eats anything. And
not anything.
Well, excuse me, most things. And so he just was not able to keep the weight on. Everything he was eating, he was using right away. And so we were, for almost a year, we were up a pound, down a pound, up a pound, down a pound. And probably about 6 months ago, the doctor suggested maybe we should think about putting in a feeding tube. Well, I saw it as giving up.
Mm-hmm.
Mom and the doctors were saying, you know, this is a smart thing to do. We need to do this and everything. And Dad was being stubborn.
Right.
Dad was like, no, we're going to try everything we can try first here at the house. And so we did. We made high-calorie things, you know, make Richard Simmons roll over.
Right.
And everything I could think of to put extra fat into it. And it just wasn't helping. And so I finally said, okay, we'll try it. And so we did it. And literally within 3 days, we saw results.
Wow.
It has been truly amazing. We went in at 37 pounds. And the last time we took a weight was 43 1/3, and that was just about, what, maybe about 3.5 weeks after the surgery was done.
We gained 5.5 pounds in a month. Our goals used to be 1 to 2 pounds in about 2 to 3 months. If we could put on 2 pounds between appointments, it was seen as a major success. And here we are, 5.5 in simply 1 month, and it's just, the procedure wasn't easy, and mm-hmm. I completely understand, you know, the taking the time to make the decision, because it was surgery. It was actually putting a hole in his stomach and putting a tube in. And every night we hook him up to a bag of formula, like on an IV pole in a little machine, and it basically lets him stay at an all-night buffet. He takes in 900 calories every night, and in the morning he's stuffed, but it's sticking. And we are just so excited. It's probably the best medical news we've had in his lifetime for how he's doing.
Wow. That's amazing.
Thank you.
You are welcome. Well, we want everybody, like I said earlier, to come out to the Great Strides Walk. You can all be a part of the Peanut Patrol and help raise money for cystic fibrosis. Mount Pleasant, Palmetto Island.
You change a lot of kids' lives.
It sure will. So come on out Saturday, May 2nd at 9 o'clock. Thank you guys for coming by.
The money will be spent well.
What was that, Joey?
Your money will be spent well. 95 SX.